go into your families and teach them what Allah Samad means. Everybody recites, Allahu Ahad, Allah, Qul Huwa Allah, Allahu Samad. What is Allah Samad? Tell them, you know what Allah Samad means? We spent years, some people spent years and decades of their life and they still don't know who we do. Who do we worship? SubhanAllah. We believe that we are, why are we Muslims? Why is Allah worthy of being worshipped, subhanahu wa ta'ala? Huh? Allah Samad. Allah Samad. Allahu Ahad, Allah Samad. La yalid wa lam yulad. How can? Impossible. Yalid and yulad, who does that? Creation. Allah is telling you in every ayah, I am not like the creation. Don't ascribe him to the creation. لَمْ يَلَدْ وَلَمْ يُولَدْ. Not only that, nothing is like him. وَلَمْ يَكْوَنْ لَهُ كُفْوًا أَحَدْ. Nothing is compared to him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. خَالِقٌ بِلَا حَاجَةٌ. Allah هو الخالق. The meaning of خالق means this. The one who brings entities from the state of non-existence into a state of existence. No one creates in this meaning but Allah. Can you bring anything from non-existence into existence? Let me know. Anyone. People say, I made a car. You assembled the car. Did you make a car? Try to make a car from nothing. Let me see. Huh? Anyone who can do anything, let me tell us. أم خلقوا من غير شيء بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم خلقوا من غير شيء أم هم الخالقون were they created from nothing or are they creators let me see people don't create people assemble they assemble Allah's creation Allah creates جل جلاله bringing things from non-existence into existence no one does that except Allah سبحانه وتعالى جل جلاله الله 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 رازقان بلا مؤنة He sustains without difficulty or without an effort. When you sustain a family, what do you have to do? You have to work, right? Unless you're lucky. May Allah make you all lucky. They have to work, they have to suffer, they come home. And the wife says, oh, well, no. Give me some money to buy some clothes tomorrow. I need to go to the shopping center. Of course, their requests never finish, right? They think you have Bank of Scotland behind you. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina Muhammad. Our sisters are great, alhamdulillah. That's not to belittle them. May Allah give them knowledge and raise their rank so they can build a new generation that carries the message of Islam. But you have to go work. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you look at this ayah, it's okay to a little bit come out of aqidah. So I know that I'm throwing all this information on you and people are starting looking around the sky. You know. When Adam عليه السلام or حواء عليه السلام they were in the Jannah, Allah told them, don't eat from this tree. Don't eat from that tree. فأزلهم الشيطان عنها. فأخرجهم مما كان فيه. قلنا اهبطوا. Allah told them, now you go to earth. Another ayah, Allah tells Adam, that a shaitan should not fool you, Adam. فَتَشْقَى فَتَشْقَى تَشْقَى means you will suffer. He didn't say فَتَشْقَيَا that both of you will suffer. Look at this. While when he said go down to earth, he said both of you اهبطوا منها both of you go down. Huh? From Jannah, go down to earth. So both they go down to earth, but يا Adam فَتَشْقَى You, Adam, you will suffer because you have to go earn. So that's why Islam necessitates that a man must provide, even if his wife works. It's your obligation to provide. And you have no right of her money either. And you know she can charge you for cooking, right? I'm trying to, after I said all that comment about females, I'm trying to score some points. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala al Sayyidina Muhammad. If she wants to wash your clothes or she wants to cook your food, by fiqh, yani according to Shafi'i and Maliki Madhab and others, she can actually charge you for that. If you want me to cook for you, that's a job, I have to charge you. She's not there to clean or cook for you, she's there to raise your kids. So have appreciation also. Now we'll create a revolution. They will come with like these bands, no cooking anymore. Three no's, no cooking, no washing, no laundry, no. وعلى آله محمد وبارك وسلم. So therefore the man has to provide. That's among the things. You have to provide. But you don't have to live in Beverly Hills. You can live decent living, inshallah. You don't have to buy Rolls Royce. You can buy Toyota. Honda Civic, alhamdulillah, that will do the job. Or Hyundai. These Korean made cars. Or that smart. I don't know how smart that is. You know, if you get an accent, you'll be sardines. That's not very smart, is it? They call it smart. Smart. They call these names. People, of course, people buy. Whatever they send them to the market, people buy. Alhamdulillah. Huh? Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is... When He sustains, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and everything is sustained by Allah. It's without an effort or a difficulty. Wallahu khayru raziqeen. Allahu khayru raziqeen. I said today, earlier, your rizq will come to you. Allah guaranteed everyone that is born, rizq. Everyone that is born, Allah guaranteed him rizq. Don't worry about that. Don't spend your life in what He guaranteed you. Spend your life in what you need, that is required from you. Spend your life in trying to know what He, to obey what He told you, Jalla Jalaluhu. And I'll say this again. It's very important to understand that. Some people think that rizq is their income or their money or what they make. What they have, what they own, that's their rizq. That is not true. What you own is not necessarily your rizq. What your income is, what your salary is not necessarily your rizq. What you have is not necessarily yours. You have it, but it's not yours. It's never going to be yours. Huh? Sometimes it's never going to be yours. Huh? And I gave this example earlier today. I said, some people, they want to just increase their money. In any way, shape, or form. Halal, haram, no problem. Huh? Let me just do it. And after that, so you increased your money from halal or haram. So you think now you're increasing your money, you're not. You're increasing your rizq, you're not. The money you have in the bank may be increased, but your rizq is not increased. Your rizq is the same. You just don't realize it. So you go, and you buy food. On the way coming home, someone comes and steals it. Well, you suffer to make money from haram and someone comes and steals your food. It's not yours. It's not meant to be yours from the beginning. It's meant to be for that one who stole it. He's not gonna eat it, you're not gonna eat it. You take it and you forget it in the taxi cab or on the bus or on the train. You bought it from halal or haram, halal. Huh? Even from halal, it's not supposed to be yours. You'll forget it in the train and you'll come home. Where is it? I forgot it. It's not meant to be yours. It's not that you forgot it. It's not meant to be yours. It's not yours. It's not your food. It's not your rizq. You bought it. It was with your money. It's not your rizq. No. I brought it and I'm going to eat it. Huh? So here, you come and you bring it and you chew it. Huh? You eat it. You eat the whole meal. Just make sure so that, you know, I'm going to make sure I get it. Allah still tells you it's not yours. It gets to your stomach and something comes out and then you vomit this whole food. comes out of you, right on the floor, you see one fly, two flies, three flies come, and they start eating it. It's dead as if not yours.